Metzger-Timson's have the answer for you. Trivia with a star or two.
They've got multiple choice and name that voice.
When the guest stars sing, everyone will rejoice.
So grab a drink,
turn your brain on and think.
It's MT Trivia
with the MT.
Oh my God.
Hi.
I'm in the same shirt as in the intro. It's like we just filmed it.
Oh my gosh. It's like it just happened. I'm in my Bernadette living at the end of a number pose shirt.
Listen, we are here with musical theater trivia. It is our last episode before our summer vacation.
Can so
we are living
it?
Our musical theater dreams.
It is the season finale, bitches. And we're very excited to be here. I'm Chris MT.
I'm Kevin MT.
And together we are the MTs at MT Trivia.
Yes.
That's how it works. We're so excited for our show tonight, and we have had quite a wild ride getting here. Tell us the numbers. This is our 37th episode,
37.
Which means we have had 36 episodes so far. We have had
how many?
72. Yes.
Yep.
Math. That's math. And we have raised thousands of dollars for very important causes and charities that we believe in with your help.
And we're still doing that tonight.
We're still doing it.
This final episode, as we were doing all through the month of May, we are raising money for the Fund for College Auditions. What's the Fund for College Auditions, you may ask? Let me tell you. They raise money to help underprivileged and low-income students who want to study musical theater afford the expenses that go with applying for these conservatory and BFA programs. So they provide everything from training on the audition material to shoes if you need it for the dance calls to application fees to tutors for the SAT and all the tests you have to do.
They literally guide them through the entire process, and they are primarily focused but not limited to those who identify as BIPOC, trans, non-binary, disabled, neurodiverse, and weight diverse. And so we are really happy to support them to make sure that we see an equitable representation on Broadway, just like we are here in the world.
We are working towards a better industry, a better Broadway, both on stage and behind the scenes. And it has to start at the college level, because we have to provide resources for these students to learn the business and grow. And so that's what the fund does. We feel very passionate about it. We hope you do. Check them out on Instagram at the Fund for College Auditions.
And so if you are having fun tonight and you would give us a tip, if we were at a gay bar and you would like give us a little dollar or two, just please.
I hope they'd give me a little bit more than a dollar or two.
Amen.
If I was at a gay bar.
You can Venmo us at MT-Trivia, and we're going to donate 100% of those tips tonight, as we have all month, to the Fund for College Auditions. So thank you so much for helping us support them.
But enough about us and that, because we have, well, not enough, because there'll be more coming, but we have two very special guests tonight. When we thought about the way we wanted to go out with a bang on MT Trivia, only two names came to mind, and we got them both tonight.
Oh.
They are former stars of the national tour of Kinky Boots.
Kinky Boots, which we saw in Orange County.
We sure did.
We saw that production. And then our first guest went on to make her Broadway debut as Pamela in Head Over Heels, Princess Pamela. She is quite the star of the New York City cabaret circuit. And you may have seen her as Katherine in Search Party. I have been living for that.
If you have not watched Search Party, she plays Katherine. Was it Witherbottom?
Something like
Witherbottom.
We're way behind, and we're like just on like season two. And
she is a Westchester, Long Island princess extraordinaire.
It is truly everything. And she is a Beltress to end all Beltresses. It is the one and only Bonnie Milligan.
And he is, I would say, the longest running Lola, but we'll have to fact check that when he...
Fact check us on that, but
when
we think it's true.
Us. He's also the final Lola on Broadway. He was seen in... when Broadway reopens, we'll be seen in Doubtfire on Broadway.
Yes.
It's the one, the only, Jay Harrison G.
Woo! Hi, I'm Jay Harrison G. And I got a lacy, silky feel with arms as hard as steel. I am freedom, I'm constriction, a potpourri of contradiction. That humdrum pace of glum behind. Once you walk inside these doors, you're mine. Now let me blow your mind in light to day.
Yeah.
happened? I hit it. We're starting over. You got to catch these clips.
You got to hear.
Hi, I'm Jay Harrison G, and I got a lacy, silken feel with arms as hard as steel. I am freedom. I'm constriction. A potpourri of contradiction. Leave that humdrum pace of glum behind. Once you walk inside these doors, you're mine. Now let me blow your mind and light your day.
Listen, I'm not mad that we had to start that over because I'd watch those clips on loop.
I just have like, it like suddenly catch me and I'm like opening the wine and I'm like,
well, welcome to the show, y'all. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Thank you for having
welcome,
us.
Welcome, welcome. So y'all did the Kinky Boots tour together, correct? That's how
we did.
How we met and the love bond formed.
Yeah. Very deeply.
And when do we get you guys on stage together again? What show are we gonna put you in?
Let's make it happen, okay?
Yeah. Name it. We're in.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Coming to Broadway in 2023, headliners.
That I Met a Girl, Bonnie, is some of your finest work. I just can't get over it. But the Deborah Monk of it all, the production number of it all, the whole thing. It's just like, you guys, everyone go watch. Was it Broadway Backwards?
Yes.
It was Broadway Backwards, yeah.
Broadway Backwards. Everyone Google that clip. It's so good.
And also just to get to share the stage with Deborah Monk, and I don't know if you noticed her shawl, that is the iconic Everybody's Girl shawl from the Carnegie Hall concert that we all, I'm sure,
I did not pick up on that. That's fierce.
That's
she brought it to rehearsal and like five of us were like, excuse me, I'm so sorry, is that the Everybody's Girl shawl? She was like, no, it's different. And then we're like, no. And she's like, oh, I did it in that one concert. We're like, that's the one we know. That's it.
I love that. And Jay, I wasn't lying when I said you're the longest running Lola, right? Most performances? Come on.
I never fact checked that for myself. I think Billy was there for quite a while himself. But
like between tour and Broadway, you've got to have performed it the most out of anybody, right?
Quite possibly, maybe.
And you heard it here first, folks.
Some of the audience start counting performances now, and by the end of the show,
we'll have an answer. Just throw it in the chat.
I love it. Speaking of our show, we have three very exciting rounds of musical theater trivia tonight. How are we both feeling about our musical theater trivia? Do we remember our history?
No, absolutely not. I will absolutely embarrass myself tonight.
Well, we love to see it.
Usually I feel good about it, but as soon as I say that out loud, I'm going to be trash tonight.
But here's the thing. You're not alone, right? You have each other and you have the audience at home to help you out. So if you're playing along at home, we encourage you to throw your answers in the chat. We'll be putting them up on the screen. You are their lifeline. We're counting on you. So help us out here. And our first round, without further ado, I think we should announce is
A Simple Choice.
A simple choice, nothing more. This or that, either or.
So, as you may have guessed, this is the multiple choice portion of the evening. And I was like searching for like inspiration. We like to theme each round. And I was like, what's it gonna be? It's the finale. And you know what? It's just so damn hot in my apartment that I said that we should focus on musicals.
About heat,
where it's okay. Really hot.
So
each of the musicals has an iconic line or song about it being effing hot. All right, so this first one, it's gonna be another hot day.
And don't forget, you at home are playing along, so throw your answers in the chat, help our guests out.
All
right,
here
we go.
Composers Harvey Schmidt and Tom Jones wrote 114 songs for 110 in the Shade before settling on the final numbers. Which song was restored in the acclaimed 2007 revival starring Audra McDonald and John Cullum? Was it 110 in the Shade, Evening Star, A Man and a Woman, Too Many People Alone, or Raunchy? Which song was cut from the original but restored for the iconic revival?
What?
Raunchy?
I want to say that as well. I think it's raunchy.
It just feels like back in the day, they'd be like, that's too much!
Right.
No, we couldn't possibly.
And then they're like, let Audra do it.
Well, that's, of course, famously the number where she did the cartwheel off the table.
Yes.
Let us not
iconic.
Forget.
What does the audience at home think? Do we have
somebody said, just Dolphy said B.
We've got an
Evening
E,
Star.
Evening Star. Okay, but we've got another E. Steph, all right, well.
A Man and a Woman, that could get a little spicy too.
Right, a little for the 1960s audience, a little
too much. It could.
Too Many People Alone. You know what, I'm going to.
This is a very sultry score.
Let's go A Man and a Woman.
A Man and a Woman. Bonnie, final answer. Okay. Jay, what's your final answer?
I'm going to stick with raunchy because I like to be raunchy.
I love it.
All right. Well, to both of you, I'm going to have to say.
Oh.
Wrong.
What are you going to have to say?
Oh, I'm apparently not connected. What's going on?
We don't know, but we're going to have to say, hell no.
What's going on?
You can't stay here, girl.
Oh, you know what? Here we go.
There we go.
Hell no.
That means you got it wrong.
That means it's wrong. The correct answer was Evening Star. It's a song for the leading man. He sings it at the top of Act Two, and they put it back in for the revival. There you go.
Well, I'm glad about that other song.
But Raunchy was like always in there, honey. She was always like giving it to you, even back in the day.
Keep the raunch.
I do like that song. I like the girl. It lets people go a little wild. Show us your wild side.
A little raunchy,
if you will.
All right. Our next hot musical, Someone Ought to Open Up a Window.
Oh, Lord.
1776. Oh.
Which of these statements is not true regarding the original Broadway production of 1776?
Oh, my God.
So they're all true except one. You got to find the lie.
Ooh,
it was the first complete Broadway show to be staged at the White House. It holds the record for longest time in a musical without a single note played or sung. Howard Da Silva, who played Ben Franklin, suffered a heart attack during the final preview, but still went on for opening night.
Workhorse.
Producer Stuart Ostro originally proposed calling the show Fireworks, or it was the first musical ever written about American independence.
I feel like I know B is correct. that leaves me with so many more.
Okay, there are so many options, okay?
Because it's like a 40-minute scene with no songs.
Right, but that's not a...
Which, I'm sorry, that's a play. Let's just call it what it is. It's a play with music. If I'm sitting in a Broadway house for 40 minutes and not hearing that orchestra, I'm in a play.
Yeah, B is definitely right. That's right.
Sadly, I did a reading of this, and I should know things more.
I was going to say, I was like, you've done the show, right?
I did a reading, yeah.
Which founding father were you?
I was Richard Henry Lee.
Yes.
Yeah.
Famously of Virginia?
Yes, of Virginia, correct.
Lee.
Also, a Tony Award-winning role from the original production.
I know. I mean, has there ever been a Broadway show at the White House? I feel like that doesn't track.
Yeah, I feel like that's something we would like know.
We would have heard about it.
A show being staged at the White House.
I mean, I kind of wish it was C. I feel bad, Howard Da Silva. But I feel like that tracks. You know, somebody's like, I'm doing it. Because he was kind of like famous. He would have just been like, I'm doing this.
I'm doing it. I'm getting out there. What does our audience have to say? We've got
a lot of A's.
Got a lot of A. A lot of White House A.
A lot of White House.
But also, is there any other, I don't know, is there any other, are there other government musicals? American Independence musicals?
Before 1776, obviously, like, Hamilton has taken this on.
The Patriots coming to Broadway as a musical.
Yes. 76 was like, was that like 1970, 1960s? When did that come out?
I believe it was 1969. Okay. Fact check me on that. I'm making that up.
We're just making
it feels right. I did a lot of research today, but
I feel like maybe somebody did a musical before that. I'm gonna go wild. I'm gonna say E.
I'm getting a thumbs up from our producer. I was 1969. Right. 1969. You're welcome.
Good guess, Christopher.
Yes.
Bonnie gives the final answer E.
I'm doing it. E. I'm just. Oh God.
Okay, and MJ.
I'm gonna go with A. I'm gonna go with the audience on this one.
Okay.
All right. So Jay, I'm gonna have to say
hell no.
And to Bonnie, I'm gonna have to say
first part of the night, baby.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
It was not the first musical ever written about the American independence. The first musical was in 1925. Rodgers and Hart wrote a musical about the American Revolution called Dearest Enemy. And then another one in 1950 was called Arms and the Girl, with music by Morton Gould and lyrics by Dorothy Fields and a book by Herbert Fields. There you go.
I heard they're doing Arms and the Girl at the Muni this summer, so be sure to check it out.
Jeff, it's a classic.
Classic. It's a hit.
Yeah, my brothers in the chat. Seven brothers.
Hello, Tim Milligan.
Tim's here.
Tim Milligan. That's my bro.
That's your his sis.
Oh, what a cute little photo of him. That was cute. Okay.
Shout out. All right.
We love to see it.
Well done, Bonnie. First point of the night. We're going to go on to our next hot, hot musical, which is obviously I Got Steamy.
I like that written out phonetically.
You're welcome. I had to Google, like, how do people write this? And that's the most popular answer.
There you go.
All right. The Pajama Game launched the career of this famous Hollywood actress who understudied the role of Gladys and temporarily took over the role when Carol Haney injured her ankle. This was like the OG Peggy Sawyer of it all, you guys. Like, real life story. Was it Shirley MacLaine, Anne Margaret, Shirley Jones, Debbie Reynolds, or Mitzi Gaynor?
Oh God, I feel like they were all famous before. Oh no.
One of these iconic women was the understudy that went on and became a star.
Well, this is very famously the story where when she had to go on, it was so sudden they didn't even have shoes for her. Mm-hmm. I think she had to like spray paint her like sneakers for the number.
I think it's either Shirley MacLaine or Debbie. No, Debbie Reynolds was before.
It was Shirley. I mean, I feel like Shirley was a Broadway gal. I didn't realize this was what launched her. But that tracks for me. Shirley Jones like walked into audition for Oklahoma and they're like, God, you're beautiful. Put her in the movie. And she was like famous.
Yes. That's true.
I feel like Anne Margaret was already like a teenager, like being hot and doing things with Elvis. I don't know what year this was.
That was her thing.
That's just like
iconically her thing. Being hot with Elvis.
Iconically be hot with Elvis. Mitzi Gaynor. I'm gonna say Shirley MacLaine, I think.
Okay.
They're saying Shirley Jones.
You got your brother is saying Shirley Jones.
Do you go with the audience or do you go with
Timothy? No.
You're sticking with MacLaine.
Shirley MacLaine.
My cousin's here, Cassidy. Look
the whole fam.
Family affair. I love it.
Cool. All right. So you're both going A?
I'm gonna go A.
Final answer.
Nervous.
Yes. Isn't there some famous story? There was a Hollywood producer in the audience, and he he saw Shirley MacLaine go on, and he went after her and he said, "Get out to Hollywood, girl!" And she went and never looked back.
They wrote her a contract, like right away, to be in a, you know, one of the studios. I don't know which one. But yeah, she
that's
like,
amazing.
Literally, it just she did the role for like a few months, and that was like the launch of her career. Crazy, right?
I love that. I'm a big Doris Day fan. I love that movie.
Oh, so good.
That whole show is
so good.
Great show. All right. Great show for, there it is. That would be a good show for the two of you.
Yes. Let's
yes.
do it.
Oh, I'd love to see that.
At all in love.
Yeah.
We're ready.
Yes, all right. Please.
Our next one. It's too darn hot. All right. Kiss Me, Kate opened on Broadway in 1948 and has been revived on Broadway 3 times. Which of these statements is not true of Kiss Me, Kate? I'm sorry.
You
I
love another
again.
Knot. You love another
I
knot.
Love a knot. I
you
like
love a knot.
To, listen, I get more history into the question this way. All
That's
right. Here
true.
We go. All right, which of these statements is not true?
All are true but one?
Exactly.
Find the lie?
Find the lie.
Okay.
It was the recipient of the first Tony Award for Best Musical. It was Cole Porter's only show to run more than 1,000 performances on Broadway. The show's book writers, Bella and Samuel Spiewak, are said to have based the plot loosely on their own marital disputes while starring in a production of Taming of the Shrew. The 1999 revival holds the record for most Tony nominations for a musical revival. And the original cast recording of the 1948 Broadway production was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 1998.
What?
One of these statements is not true.
Oh, y'all couldn't even like help us out a little bit. Y'all had to like.
We gotta get the history in there
this
for
is
the
a
kids.
Historical
okay, all right.
Musical.
Oh God, what are the audience saying? Kiss Me, Kate. Oh no.
Oh.
So that 1999 revival is famously the Mary Maisie, Brian Stokes Mitchell revival.
Well, here's a fun fact while we're
recorded
thinking.
For DVD with Rachel York.
Of
My
course.
Yes, in England, yes.
Yeah.
The recent revival starring Kelly O'Hara, when she made her grand entrance at the top of the show, she was wearing Mary Maisie's hat.
I didn't know that. That's really good.
Yes.
That's really beautiful.
An homage.
Oh my gosh. I feel like I did. Was 1948 the first year they had a Best Musical Tony?
Right, that's what keeps ringing in my spirit.
You
as
tell
well,
us. Tonight. You tell us.
But if it was, then it would track that it would line up with E, that they're like, this is an iconic first. Let's also put her in that
uh-huh,
whole
uh-huh,
thing.
Uh-huh,
I see, uh-huh. I see your
process of elimination here. Here we go.
We got a guess for D.
But does the. I was about to say, I really don't feel like it. Holds the record for most nominations for.
I know. I'm like, what are their revival?
For a revival.
Yes,
not for
a revival.
For a revival.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
What are we thinking?
I'm saying D.
You're going D. Mm. Don't believe in the revival. What do you think, Bonnie?
Oh, no. I'm between A and D. I don't know when musicals started getting Tonys.
That was the sweetest.
Aren't they like?
I just
aren't they like 80 more. Years old? Haven't we had a lot of Tony Awards?
We've had a lot of Tony Awards.
I'm gonna go with A. I don't. I'm just. Oh God. Okay.
You're going with.
She's
a.
going A.
We've got an A and a D, and I'm going to have to say to both of you.
What is it?
So the Tony Awards did begin in 1948, and it was the very first Tony Award for Best Musical went to Kiss Me, Kate.
Okay.
It was Cole Porter's only show that played over 1,000 performances, and
however,
the revival of the Mary Maisie, Brian Stokes Mitchell revival received 12 Tony nominations and still is the record holder for the most Tony nominations for a Broadway revival.
Okay.
And the Grammy thing is true. So the correct answer is that it was not based on the book
their
writers.
Relationship.
They were actually husband and wife, but it was not based on their lives. So unfortunately.
I love how I just incorrect. Didn't even like read that one. I was like, whatever, what are the other ones?
Well, that one made sense.
I feel like
it was like,
also,
I feel like writers would do that. They would,
it's
yeah.
true.
Yes.
But this really
can kind of fake when we talk about it though.
Yeah. So. This really conveniently brings us to our Broadway bonus. So the Broadway bonus famously has no multiple choice. And the question is, which famous Broadway couple actually provided the inspiration for Kiss Me, Kate. So it was actually inspired by a real life,
before 1948,
a real life actor actress couple, iconic Broadway couple.
The correct answer is not Jennifer Aniston and Brad Pitt.
And
sorry,
they
folks.
Were famously appearing in a production of Taming of the Shrew, in which this show is based.
In the 40s,
loosely.
I feel like
based.
I have heard this answer, and I'm going to be mad when you say it because it will not come to me because I have heard this before.
Not like Katherine Hepburn and Spencer Tracy or something. I'm just trying to think of like
no, but that is a very good guess. More theater, less Hollywood.
Focus on the theater.
I know.
I'm not gonna. Yeah, no.
Does anyone in the audience know?
Theater.
Monk and Fontaine.
They were a Broadway, like at Broadway performers, or you're not telling me that?
They were performing in a production of Taming of the Shrew.
Right.
And that inspired this this book.
Yeah, I'm not going to pretend.
The show. But they've done it all, I shall say.
They've done it all. When you say it.
Oh, yeah.
They've done it all. Is that a hint? And I don't know what it means.
Oh, wait.
Say it again, Jay.
Oh, God. So I must have said something that hinted towards it.
What did you just say?
I don't know. I just said they've done it all.
No, it's not Maltby and Shire.
It has nothing to do with Maltby and Shire.
Kiss Me, Kate is not based on Maltby and Shire.
Oh, so what?
Okay.
We have it in
the audience. We've got it here.
Oh,
the correct answer is Alfred Lunt and Lynn Fontaine. The historic couple. They have a Broadway theater named after them. And they were the inspiration, loosely based on their marital disputes during Taming of the Shrew in 1935. Kiss Me, Kate was born.
Who knew?
There it is. I know.
Well, you kind of took that and made it the fake answer of the other question.
Exactly.
Do you see how his brain works now?
I see your wizardry. Yeah. Okay.
All right. Now you know how my brain works. All right. It's hot up here. It's hot and it's monotonous. During Sunday in the Park with George, every character in the park scene painted by George Surratt complains about the heat. What in particular is vexing the soldier?
Oh, dang it.
He's not in the shade. His helmet, that monkey. He's not in propulsion, or his companion's a bore.
I'm just going to jump in. I'm going to guess E, because one of those girls is annoying.
What are they called? The Lucilles?
Yeah, right? The Lucilles, right?
Somebody. I'm going to go with A. He's not in the shade.
So we've got A, he's not in the shade, and E, his companion's a bore.
No.
I'm so sorry. You're both incorrect. The correct answer, which rhymes with monotonous, is these helmets weigh a lot on us.
Heavy helmets.
I should have listened
weighing
to my
on him. I know it's a small detail in an iconic show, but
I just tried to jump in the deep end for the first time. Usually I overthink it. It didn't work.
But you know what?
You win some, you lose most. It's fine.
You win some, you lose most. But you know what? That's only the end of round one, and we still have two more rounds of trivia.
Yes. And I'm going to do some calculations while Kevin reminds you why we're all here.
We're here to have a lot of fun tonight with our friends Bonnie and Jay, but also we're raising money for the Fun for College Auditions. Catch them on Instagram at the Fun for College Auditions. And if you're having fun, or if you've had fun with us all season long, throw us a tip via Venmo at MT-Trivia. 100% of the tips we collect will be donated to the fund.
Yes.
How are we looking, babe?
We're looking good. I think Bonnie's like slightly in the lead.
Ooh.
She got that first question, and then we've been kind of tied ever since. Ooh. But we have two more rounds coming your way, so there's plenty of chance for Jay to catch up.
And what's our next round?
Our next round is my favorite round, which is called Name That Diva.
It's hard to be the diva. It's hard to be divine. To live the life of fever with your guts on the line. It's hard to be the diva. The stories I could tell. My life may seem like heaven, baby, but is it hell?
It's hard. Oh, it's hard. All right, Name That Diva is, of course, famously our audio round where we're going to play you some iconic Broadway divas, and you're going to tell us who's singing.
All
simple.
You have to do is who is singing, but there are rules.
There's always rules.
Because our audience is on a little bit of a delay because of, you know, the internet. When we're going to play the whole clip. When you think you know the answer, you're going to raise your hand. You're going to say, I know it. And then we will go to whoever raises their hand first for the steal at the end of the clip. And that means if you're playing along at home and you think you know it, throw it in the comments as soon as you know the answer so that we can put your answer up on the screen and help these guys out.
Go right ahead and throw that in there.
Yeah.
So tonight we decided, you know, over the past season, we've had a lot of Name That Divas. We've done soprano moments. We've done belting moments. But this week,
that was a tip.
We got a tip.
Ooh, come on, tip.
Come on, come through, tip. This week in
Alex,
there she is in the fan. Speaking of, it's hot. This week for Name That Diva, I decided to get very classy. And in honor of Sunday in the Park with George, we're going to play Name That Move On.
Or Name That
Dot.
We're going to listen to the song.
We're going to listen to Dot sing Move On. All right. Not all of these women have played it in a fully staged production. Some might be from concerts. So
But they're iconic.
So remove all productions from your brain. We're broadening our horizons. And here is our first Dot.
Our first Dot.
Coming to you right now.
I love this song.
Stop worrying where you're going. Move on. If you can know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on. I chose and my world was shaken so hard. The choice may have been mistaken. Choosing was not, you have to move on. Move on, not at where you are, not at what you'll be. Look at all the things you've done for me. Opened up my heart.
All right.
Any ideas?
It is very slow. You're right.
It is.
We're really taking our time.
Slowest clip. They speed up as we go.
That's, God.
I got very Laura Osnes vibes.
Okay. All right.
Yes, but no. It's also not SJB.
You got a lot of SJB in the comments.
Not like a not Liz Calloway.
No, ma'am.
Ooh, but also a good
closer to that.
No, that was not.
She had moments of Liz.
Rose, we would not go that easy on you. I can tell you all right here and now, we are not playing Bernadette Peters singing this song.
She's on the
measure. Too iconic.
I was like, that would be too, like, yeah, we would
too
all
too iconic. Like, yeah. We're not going that easy on you, Rose Taylor.
Oh, God. I feel
bad.
I'm not, it sounds so familiar. It's kind of driving me crazy. I feel like heard.
Okay, let's play the very beginning again.
We'll play it one more time. It's a Tony Award winner.
Big vowels.
Yes.
Yes.
Famous for British mega musicals.
Lea Salonga.
Ah!
It's that mix. I had bits of Liz in there. It's like, I was like, it's not Liz, but it's that placement.
It's that
placement. It's like a little rounder than Liz.
Yes.
Like,
yes. Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, God. I'm so sorry. That took too long.
Oh, gosh. It's okay. We love
you. You got there eventually. You got there eventually. Here's our next Dot. Here we go. Dot number two. Oh, Dot number two.
Stop worrying where you're going. Move on. If you can know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on.
So good.
I know this voice.
I chose and my world was shaken. So what? The choice may have been mistaken. The choosing was not. You have to move on.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Confident in it.
Not at what you'll be.
Yeah.
Look at all the things you've done for me.
I can't.
Open up my eyes. Taught me how to see.
Bonnie.
Barbara Cook.
Oh, Barbara Cook. Just like
I know the end. It's like the end of the phrase. Yes.
Just like, oh, like
it's like
the best vocals.
You know what
time.
It is? It's like listening to caramel.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like melts.
Ooey gooey.
Yeah. Ooey ooey gooey.
I mean, come on.
Ooey gooey deliciousness.
Oh, we love. Oh my gosh, Barbara Cook, iconic Sondheim interpreter, and we just
Yeah.
Can't get enough. All right. Our next dot is
coming to you now.
Wait.
I chose my world to shake him. So what?
I think.
The choice may have been mistaken, but the choosing was not. You have to look at all the things you've done for me.
Ooh, ooh, ooh.
Oh, dear. Yeah.
Oh.
Bonnie?
Yes, Alex, that's what I was about to say. I feel like that's SJB.
Oh, yes, Linda, those vowels. Good choice, though.
That was, those vowels.
Yes.
Yes.
The spin.
It's also the passion she gives every time. She's 110%. She's yes. in.
Yeah, it's that her and I feel like Carolee Carmello have that, like, everything they sing is like so dramatic all the time. Like, it's like the stakes are 200 always.
You're like, thank you for listening. Good. What?
My yeah.
Yeah, yeah. Oh my gosh, yes. We love Stephanie J. Block.
Yes, we love an SJB moment. All right, here's our next dot. Here we go. Oh, I moved the screen. Here we go. It's coming.
Stop worrying where you're going. Oh. If you can know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on. I've chosen my world was shaken, so what? The choice may have been mistaken. The choosing was not. You have to go.
Is that right?
You want, not at where you are. Not
I don't know.
What you'll be.
You got
look
it?
At all the things you've done for me. Opened up my eyes, taught me how to see.
Jay, do you have a guess?
No.
The audience is Carmen Cusack.
All right, audience, you got it.
The audience gets that point.
Oh,
when
I was...
Yes, Carmen Cusack. Oh my gosh. She must have been so good in that role. She played the role with opposite Jason Danielli.
Jason Danielli was her, George.
Ugh.
We love to see it.
There's a really good full clip of that song on the YouTube. Go check it out.
If you are into
Bootleg. Jason Danielli do that.
Right?
Oh, so good.
All right, we got one last dot for you.
One last dot.
One last dot. Here we go.
Come at me. Come on!
I mean, look, watch me get it wrong still.
Oh. All right, we're gonna have you say it together. One, two, three.
Audra McDonald.
Audra.
Yes, of course. She who can do no wrong.
What a beautiful interpretation. And
wait, this just in, breaking news.
Oh,
we have another Broadway bonus.
Oh my gosh.
Because there's just too many good dots out there, we got one last one to leave you with.
And this one is
this
so
might be
iconic.
The most iconic of all.
We had to.
Name this last dot. Here
the
we
most
go.
Iconic of all? Like we're giving me Bernie?
Not Bernie. Well, okay, no, fine.
Not Bernie.
Second.
I was like,
y'all.
Here we go.
Stop worrying where you're going. Move on. If you can know where you're going, you've gone. Just keep moving on. I chose that my world was shaken. So what? The choice may have been mistaken. The choosing was not. You have to move on.
The choosing was not. Is the
the cover of this album with like the like oh like little it's, flower girl hat and she's like
so good.
On it's, a stage.
We have it on so a, we have the album like the actual
Opened
record.
My eyes taught me how to see.
The audacity that you have to add drums.
Of course, like all of her Sondheim covers, they have like all new lyrics. Like she's like telling a completely
new
story.
So many
story.
Lyrics and yeah. So much rhythm she adds. You're like,
so much rhythm. That, of course, is the one and only Barbara Streisand, who we're teasing her, but of course nobody does it better. So
yes, Barbara with just B-A-B-R-A.
Just you got it. You reach a certain point in your career when you can just go, you know what? I'm gonna do whatever I want the song, and you're all gonna love it. And
like we're all gonna be there, like. Dying for
okay. Nailed it. Oh my
iconic
god.
Iconic Barbara. All right. Well,
that brings us to our third and final round,
which we like to call
Sing Out, Louise.
Sing out, Louise.
Sing for me, my meadowlark. Sing for me of the silver morning.
Well, our job here for the night is done because now we turn it over to our guests, because prior to tonight's broadcast, we sent them secret audio files that they have sworn they have not listened to. And all they have to do is finish the clip we have sent them.
All they have to do is finish the clip.
It's
and
that simple.
Listen, as we told them before the show, if you don't know the song, we really encourage you to really just find your way through it and make it up, honey. And we like to theme each of these rounds specifically to our guests. But the first round is always famously called
Songs from Your Past.
Ooh. So these are songs that you have sung in your past that it might have been a while. We're going to see if you remember them, all right?
So Jay,
hold
you're open the track labeled number one. Now I will say when I sent them to you, they may not have been in order. So make sure you open the one labeled numero uno.
I'm looking at it.
And this is a song,
this
from,
is
your
a song
past.
From your past. So whenever you're ready, sir.
Oh Lord, what have you all dug up? Okay, here we go. If you don't have STP, Crisco will do just fine. Slide some more to me. I'm beginning to feel fine. Come on and slide some more to me, girl, and let me lubricate my mind.
Where's the dance break, Jay?
Oh.
Yeah! Yes!
We lost
oh
it.
My
we
god! Did you all...
Jay, where'd you play the Tin Man and the Wiz?
Oh my god, in high school. That was actually my first production ever. I was the Tin Man. I wanted to be the Scarecrow, but we had a dude who looked like Michael Jackson, so he got the role, I think, like automatically. But I'm glad I got to be the Tin Man because it was
shot.
So much fun. Oh, I had the best time. People still call me the Tin Man from back at home, and it was the best. I did not know how to tap at the time, so I made my costume and I spray painted a pair of old Stacey Adams dress shoes I had, silver. Yeah. And just shuffled my feet and like did things. And after the show, my brother was like, dude, when did you learn to tap? That was everything.
And you're like, that was a tap.
You're like, I was making it up.
Yeah.
Well, what we love about this round for what we love about this round for our guests is that I, as a casting director, have access to a database that gives me basically every credit every actor's ever done ever in their entire life. So I hack into that database and I jig up things from the way past.
Really like to go way back.
Hence, we get a
I was like, did you pull that off the resume? Like that?
I sure did, baby boo. Yes, I sure did. And speaking of resumes, Bonnie Milligan, why don't we dig deep into your past? And you open clip number one.
Oh, God. Okay. It's loading.
It's loading.
Internet.
It's still loading. I met a man and didn't know which stars to thank. And then he asked one day if I would be his wife.
And I looked up and all that I could think of was a life I had dreamt I would live. No, wait. And I said to him, that's right, what will you give? I'll give you cars and a townhouse in Turtle Bay and a fur and a diamond ring. And we'll get married in Spain on my yacht today. And we'll honeymoon in Beijing. And we'll meet stars at the parties I throw at my villas in Nice and Paris.
Yes!
And I said, okay. And I got my yacht. It's done.
Yes!
Woo!
We won't make you go through all the acting beats. Bonnie Milligan, where did you play woman number two in Songs for New World?
I did this in Columbus, Ohio, before I moved to New York City.
Oh my gosh! Is that where you're from? Columbus, Ohio.
I went to college there. I went to Ohio State.
Yeah,
I really wish we. I mean, I would love to see your Sir by Santa sometime.
Oh, it was a good time. I also really like Just One Step. That was
fun. Oh yeah,
that is a fabulous. Murray, another show we need you both to be.
I'm right here, Murray.
And the Flag Maker. Oh God,
it's Flag Maker, the most underrated song ever.
So good.
Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, you both nailed that round.
Yeah.
Which brings us to our next round for Sing Out Louise, which is what, babe?
The next one is, okay, so you have had...
Go with us on this journey.
Okay, but like you both have had such like already such an established, fabulous
illustrious career,
and you both are so young. And so we've got so many roles ahead of us. And so these are roles that we can't wait to see you play when you're a woman of age. All right? Here we go.
Jay Harrison.
Okay. Number two.
Look into the future, if you will.
Oh, Lord, I'm nervous.
I know, me too.
Well.
Needs no excuses.
Yes.
I deal my own deck. Sometimes the ace, sometimes the deuces. It's my world that I want to have a little pride in. My world, and it's not a place I have to hide in. Your life is a sham till you can say, hey world, I am one. I am.
Yes!
Happy Pride to
girl,
that.
Happy Pride
Cheers
to that.
Oh,
actually,
my gosh.
Actually, the gag is on June 18th, I'm releasing a dance track version of that song.
Yes.
Oh, my gosh. We
yes,
cannot wait.
With Devin Lewis. Music. Yeah, Devin Lewis and Jimmy Larkin. They have produced it. And it's coming out on June 18th. I'm so excited about it. We shoot the music video on Friday. It's going to be cute.
You heard it here first, folks.
This is coming to you. The man behind Ready to Be Loved.
Ready to be loved with Kennedy Coggle.
They've been putting out dance hits to iconic musical theater numbers with iconic musical theater performers. We're so excited. Oh my gosh.
We love to see it.
Oh my God. That's so fun. Oh.
All right, Bonnie, ready for your song?
I'm so nervous that I'm
going to be. This is very high stakes.
I had a dream.
I dreamed it for you too.
Of course, she chose the Bernadette version.
Well, thanks. Oh, whoa, God! I'm supposed to go.
You can back it up.
How could you be Miss Gypsy Rodley? Well, someone tell me, when is it my turn? Don't I get a dream for myself? Starting now, it's gonna be my turn. Gangway world, get off of my runway. Starting now, I bet 1,000. This time, boys, I'm taking the 1,000. Everything's coming up roses. Everything's coming up roses. For me.
Please, somebody do the production.
Cast Bonnie Milligan as Mama Rose now.
Immediately.
Wait, I'm not old enough yet, but I have to do it one day.
I don't care.
You will be, and we'll be here for it. I cannot.
That's it. You're the next revival.
I'm the next revival.
You're the next.
Not allowed to go on.
We're waiting. We're holding.
And we're holding and holding. Holding.
I just want to produce a concert version of it just to have you sing it like next year. We'll just do it. Brilliant. All right. You both slayed that round, and I'm even more excited now for our final round, which, as you all know, tonight is our season finale, the first season of MT Trivia, the first season of Broadway Talk Live. Who knows what's coming next? And as every composer and musical theater person and director and everybody involved in the industry knows, what would a musical theater Broadway show be but without its act one finale? And so next up, we have iconic act one finales.
Here we go.
Starting with Miss B.
Ooh, okay, here we go. I'm so nervous. What is this?
I'm so nervous too.
You can say what you want. I'm not walking out. Stop all the rivers, whole strike and kill. I'm not gonna leave yet. There's no way I will. You're the best man I'll ever know. There's no way I could ever, ever go. No, no, there's no way. No, 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 no way. I'm living without you. I'm not living without you. Not living without you. I don't wanna be free. I'm staying, I'm staying. And you, and you, and you, you're gonna love me. Yeah. You're gonna love me. Yes, you are. Ooh, love me. Ooh, love me. Oh, Lord. Oh, that was it.
Yes!
Yes!
Yes! Come on, give us the final. Yes! Brilliant.
Oh, I know, I was prepared. Gosh. I was like, okay, let's keep going. No, okay.
Yeah, who knows? Who knows?
Listen, we could have kept you going, but that clip is long.
Oh my gosh.
Nailed that. Yeah. Nailed that. We love that. We love to see it. All right, Bonnie, you ready for your act one finale? Bring us home.
Here. I knew it as soon as he started. So if you care to find me, look to the western sky. As someone told me lately, everyone deserves the chance to fly. And if I'm flying solo, at least I'm flying free. To those who'd ground me, take a message back from me. Tell them, oh, I am defying gravity. I think I'll try to defy gravity, and soon I'll match them and read now. And nobody. And all of us, no wizard that there is or was, is ever gonna bring me down.
Oh,
better.
that is how we end MT Trivia, babies.
That is it. Oh my gosh, Bonnie, that was.
I may have taken an edible when I made that decision to make you sing that. So I apologize.
Jay started doing Dream Girls. I was like,
here we go.
You knew it's
here
coming.
Here we go. It's coming. Oh my gosh, so great. We're ready to hear you sing that song 8 shows a week. Let me tell you that,
please,
honey.
Please.
Oh my gosh. Ugh.
That's gonna be my new campaign. Bonnie Milligan is the next Alphabet.
Let's start a hashtag. Bonnie for Alphabet.
Get it trending. Bonnie for Alphabet. Y'all, oh my gosh. I can't even, there's nothing else to
there's
say.
Nothing
Y'all
else to
killed
say.
It. Who
this
won, baby?
Unreal. You know, I've done some very course, serious I've done some very serious calculations. But you know what? Here on MT Trivia, everyone's a winner, and
you're both winners, baby!
Wait for it.
Yes, Carolee.
We like to end every episode of MT Trivia with Carolee Carmela belting, of course.
Because what could be better than that, honey? Oh my gosh. Thank you both so much for being here for our final episode.
Jay Harris and Bonnie, thank you for being here. Their Instagram handles are scrolling across the bottom of our screen. Give them a follow. Give them some love. They're both hysterical on the social medias.
We've got some tunes coming up from Jay. We're very excited. Yes. There's so much going on.
Check them out.
We can't wait. We're so, grateful that you were here with us tonight, and now that we can all see each other in person again, let's have a drink.
We see each other, let's be live and in person.
Yes.
Yeah, let's do it.
Woo! Yes, thank you both so much.
Mwah. Thank you.
Mwah.
Everybody, this has been such a wild ride. Never in a million years did we ever think that this show would go on as long as it did and be like such a hoot and a half and such a joy to us. You have brought us so much joy from being in the audience every night and donating to, you know, all these amazing causes we've been raising money for. And we hope that we brought you some joy in this crazy, crazy year. And we are ready to have a
little summer vacation.
Little summer vacay, and we'll see you in the fall.
Be sure to follow Broadway Talk Live on all things social media to see what is coming up next for the network. There's a lot of exciting things in the work. And you know, maybe next time you'll see us, it'll be live and in person.
You never know.
Woo! So thank you so much, everyone. Have a great summer. Hags.
Bye.
Bye.